Well, hidey ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. A few months back, I did a little video on ADATs. Explored the history of ADATs a little bit, and also did some troubleshooting with some troublesome ADATs. It was called an ADAT adventure, and some of the things I had to do, you can watch that video wherever it pops up here. It'll also be in the links in the description below. But I thought I might show you guys some more stuff with ADAT. So I got another client who sent me a bunch of his ADAT tapes. Now these are three tapes that are linked together in a 24 track session. So three machines linked together. So a common question I have is people say, so how many ADAT machines do you have? Well, I have two. And they're like, well, how are you gonna link them together? So what I thought I would do is show you guys that today, how to link these tapes, how to get these tapes to transfer in sync with each other, even though I only have two machines. In this particular case, I'm actually gonna do this whole session with one, just to show you how it works. I'm just gonna use the one machine and sync all three of these tapes together and show you how it's done. It's a pretty straightforward process. You need a couple of pieces of equipment to do it, but it is not impossible. But ultimately, you know what? If you wanna give it a shot, this will show you how to do it. If not, send those tapes to me. I'll do it for you. But at any rate, so let's get to it. I'll show you how it's done. This, my friends, is the mighty BRC. So it is the BRC stands for Big Remote Control, believe it or not. So this is the piece of equipment that I use to link multiple ADAT tapes together using either one or two machines. Like I said, in this particular case, I'm just gonna use the one machine. So you see down here, I have the one ADAT machine on. There is a tape inside of it. So how we do this is using a technology called SEMTI. So you will see up here, I have my eight tracks of audio ready to record, but I also have a track called SEMTI. So what you can do with this BRC is you can generate a SEMTI code using this little function right here, generate sync. And what it's gonna do is it's going to send a signal out that I'm going to record. Then on playback, I take that track and I send it back to this machine and I say, we're gonna sync externally, external sync. So what this machine does, what the BRC then does, is listen for the time code and then lock to what's coming off of this. So now what's in logic will be coming back to the BRC. And the BRC then locks up the machine. So pretty straightforward, but let's get to it. Let's show you how it's done. So first thing, before I do anything, I'm just gonna hit play and you will start to hear that time code. And there it is. So that is the time code that the BRC is generating and that it will then listen for on playback. I'm gonna stop it right now because it's just really annoying. And while I'm doing that, I actually mute that track. So I don't have to listen to the time code. And then what we do is we transfer the first tape generating the code, then we sync the other tapes using that code. So let's start the process and get to it. So you don't necessarily have to start at zero, but I always like to start at zero. Now I've already pre-listened to this tape a little bit and I know that the music actually starts playing about a minute in, which is fairly common practice. A lot of times engineers would pre-roll not just on ADAT tape, but even regular audio tape, it is common to pre-roll a minute or 2 minutes of tape before you actually start any recorded material. That's to protect the tape, to protect the audio on that tape. This way, there's a bunch of blank tape ahead of it. So if anything environmental was going to get onto that tape, it would be affecting the outer layer of the tape, which basically is blank. And then if you're a minute or two into it, the tape is somewhat protected. So that was the theory behind doing that. But let's get to going on this. So first thing we do, I'm gonna start record on this guy. Then we're gonna press play on this. And we see our time code being generated. And I will do a quick edit and we'll come back when the audio starts playing. All right, we're almost a minute in. See right there, we're almost a minute, we're a little bit over a minute. Here comes our audio. So obviously this first tape just has drums on it. And these subsequent tapes will have more. Luckily, which is not usually the case, I have track sheets, which are great because a lot of times I get projects, not only don't they have track sheets, but they generally don't have any information. So, and I'm just kind of trying to figure my way or find my way through a plain detective. But we're underway. So what we'll do is after this tape is completely transferred, I will then show you how we sync them up. Alrighty, boys and girls, now through the magic of video editing, we are skipping ahead, so we have everything from the first tape transferred, and we see our SMPTE track up there. Now our SMPTE, which is right here, is now outputting on output 3 of the interface. So I have that coming out there with that cable going to the back of the almighty and powerful BRC, and we see we are ready for external sync, and the sync generation is turned off. Now if you notice, I press play, nothing happens, right, except that little blinking light. The machine's not moving. That's because it's waiting for the sync from here. So I listened a little bit ahead of this. Remember earlier I said, you know, that they didn't start playing until a minute in. Well, it turns out this has a little bit of music on the front end, so it almost starts playing almost immediately, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, it's just a thing. Sometimes the sync can take a couple of seconds to sync up, so we may have to try this a couple of times to make sure we're getting everything, because there is a count in. It counts off 1, 2, 3, and then the guitar starts. So we may have to do that a couple of times to make sure we get that. But what we'll do is we will hit record here. That will then output the SMPTE to the BRC. The BRC will then sync to the ADAT machine. Sorry for all the sudden movements there. Hopefully it's not making anybody ill. But but that's what we're going to do. So let's give it a shot. Here we go. See, it's got its empty in, so now it's starting to sync. And we're waiting for that to... Okay, we didn't quite get lock as quickly as we would like. So we're going to try it again. Right, one more time. I actually got it to sync the second time, and of course I forgot to press play on the camera, or record on the camera. So we'll try it again. So here we go, external sync, blinky play button, we'll start recording on Logic, SMPTE, clock is running, waiting for sync,
2, 3,
we have sync, there we go. Here, because the drums kick in about a minute, but we'll edit, and so you can hear where the drums kick in. There synced. Turn the volume down a little bit here, but we will we'll basically do that with all three tapes, and we'll have a 24 track section all synced up using one ADAT machine. Again, usually I will do this with two. I'll just do the two tapes traditionally synced up, and then run the third tape using the SMPTE. But I just want to show you guys how it can be done. So we'll be back after we sync the third tape. Alrighty, so once again, we have that tape all done, synced up. So again, we've got the new tape, the third tape in. We'll do external sync. Make sure I got everything going up here. Looks good. Press play here. Blinky light. And then we start recording here. We look up here so we can make sure SMPTE's coming. Here's our SMPTE. Clock is running. And we have sync. So that is how you sync three ADAT tapes to using one machine. Just gotta have the trusty and mighty BRC at your side. Well, there you have it, boys and girls. Another successful ADAT transfer. Still going on in the background there. You get the idea. I mean, it is possible to sync these tapes up without having multiple machines. The key is that BRC. As long as you have that, you're good to go. Any questions, comments, concerns, cries of outrage, hit me up in the comments below. Oh, by the way, my shirt for the day, befitting the times, as it were. Anyway, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you're into this type of audio geekery, and we'll talk to you guys later. See ya.